welcome you to First Baptist Church tonight. We have been looking forward to this night for a long, long time. We look forward to Christmas every year. We look forward to doing Christmas music every year. But I think you're here because we do have a special treat tonight. When I came here a long time ago, Lee Black was a young teenager. And on Sunday nights, he actually was the Sunday night pianist. And I have fond memories, Lee, of watching him do four hand duets for Christmas. And I think with Angie. Is that correct? A young lady who later was killed in a terrible car wreck. But I watched these students grow up. Lee is doing exactly what he wants to do. He's writing and singing and recording. And when I saw the book this summer with his name on it, before I ever listened to the music, I thought, wouldn't it be something if we could do that and have Lee come home to sing with us? Then we stepped it up another step and said, wouldn't it be something we could get him to come home and lead the choir? So that's where we are at this time. I told you this morning he's the youngest son of Pete and Nell Black. He has brothers and a sister. His wife and two other children. Well, listen, where are you? I want our folks to see you. Where are you? Okay, right down here. Okay. Elijah's with them. Annabelle's with them. Two of their children are not here tonight. They're in a choir that's actually singing at Disney World this weekend. So they're a very, very musical family. But I want you to join me right now in welcoming back home to Monroeville, Lee Black. Would you do that, please?
Thank you. of joy and light and celebration inspires us to remember the wonderful events of a holy night long ago. We're moved to find ways to commemorate the birth of God's only Son. And we seek to understand a little more each year what it was like that night in Bethlehem.
Most of all, this season stirs within us the need to sing. To sing the old story over and over again, so that our hearts are refreshed and so that the whole world hears.
Isaiah said, "The people who walk in darkness will see a great light. For those who live in the land of deep darkness, a light will shine." Finally, after centuries of silence, prophecy became reality.
Holy, 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 holy
flocks of sheep. Suddenly, a light unlike any they've ever seen shatters the night, and a song they will never forget fills the sky. Of all the people on the planet, somehow they've been chosen to receive the glorious news. The Savior has been born in Bethlehem. Hearts pounding with excitement, they rush to find him, to fall before the manger and worship. After that, nothing in life will ever be the same. How could it be? For the rest of their days, their constant impulse is to make known what they have heard and seen.
Joseph would be called the journey and having witnessed the birth of Mary's son. Oh, but Mary. She would no doubt ponder over and over the moment she first gazed into his eyes, traced his tender cheek with her finger, and kissed his tiny forehead.
She knew the prophet's promise that he would come.
stop in just a moment. Lee's going to move to the piano and do some things by himself along with these string players. But even this one that's in the book, we've never really heard it all the way through until this afternoon, because I was supposed to be the one doing the rehearsal soloist, and I could never get us through this solo. So for us, it's the first time we've really heard it like it's supposed to be. It's a great song, Glory in the Highest.
Once again, the story of the birth of Jesus gives meaning and hope to all who believe. We're overwhelmed with thanksgiving and praise to our God.
The reality of His coming to us so humbly is more than we can comprehend. What else can we do but give Him honor as He deserves?
You are the first, you go before, you are the last, Lord.
It had a picture of a manger on the front, just a pencil sketch. And it said, away in a manger, no crib for a bed. And you opened it up, and there's a picture of a cross with Jesus right after death, with his head slumped over, and it said, the little Lord Jesus laid down his sweet head. And he said, I want to write a song that basically says that. And so this is what we wrote. It's called He Made a Way in a Manger.
Upwards of 150 songs, and
There just are not that many slots out there to fill them all. So I want to sing you one that I wrote with a friend of mine. We wrote this for Celine Dion, and she never heard it. But in my head, that's who I hear singing. I do this in the middle of it. So this one has never been cut. It's probably too artsy for anybody to cut it, but just had fun writing this. It's called A Baby in Your Arms. Because I got tired of going through the list and I go, no, couple of years ago, the Oak Ridge Boys were doing a Christmas record, and we had the opportunity to pitch this song to them, and they ended up cutting it. And that was a milestone for me, because unless you've been hiding under a rock, and people would go, "Who's got your song?" I always say, "The Oak Ridge Boys." And even if there was a look of question on my face, I'd say, "You know Elvira." "You wrote Elvira?" "No, I did not." I did not write that. So. But I wrote this one, and the Oak Ridge Boys cut it. So, anyway, at least now I can say somebody that somebody sort of knows. The Strings are going to join me on this one again. Thank you all very much. 1, 2, 3, 4.
One kind of girl would take on the world like any meaning angel would become. What kind of man would still take her hand, knowing he was the one? What kind of love, whatever it was, most people called crazy? But it would take that kind of faith, getting ready for the baby. What ugly words they must have heard, whispered as neighbors went by. Did they defend the rumors of sin? I wonder if they even tried. When I walk that road, I'll never know the best I could say is maybe. Were they all by themselves? Did they have any help getting ready for the baby? One silent night, he had changed their lives like babies always do. But Mary and Joseph had no idea how he would change. They had the job of cradling God as he entered this world to save me. All part of a plan, but so much more than getting ready for a baby. Whatever it was, someday I'll thank them for facing all the heartache they knew, everything they went through, getting ready for a baby.
For a child is born to us, a son is given to us, the government will rest on his shoulders, and he will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. reminded of the greatest gift ever given, the gift of Emmanuel.
We leave with a reawakened sense of wonder at a God who loved us so much that he sent his only son to save us.
And we renew our determination to share his story and live his gospel wherever we go. Lord, we do give you thanks tonight for bringing all the elements of this musical together in a way that shows once again your awesome glory, your power, and your love that was never more apparent than that night several thousand years ago. And Lord, I thank you for the blessing that has been for the group that performed and for the group that heard it. And Lord, we leave here determined once again to live a life that's worthy of the life that you gave for us. And I pray that everything we do and everything we say would bring glory to you and point others to you. For it's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you. Good night. Good night.